We knew it was coming. The whole thing was formulaic. First demonize InfoWars, lie about us, build a straw man, then sue us to add credibility to that, then have a few fake strikes on YouTube and Facebook with nebulous terms like bullying children and Islamophobia. And then voila, 2 weeks later, ban InfoWars completely off of dozens of major platforms where we were all in the top 5 or top 10 news feeds. CNN, MSNBC, the rest of the dying news system like the New York Times and the Washington Post, groups that are propped up by the Mexican kingpin in the case of the New York Times, Carlos Slim, in the case of the Washington Post, Jeff Bezos, they can't allow something like InfoWars with a fraction of the crew or the money to be ranked higher than them on iTunes or on YouTube. They can't stand it when people like Mark Dice has more subscribers on his channel, he doesn't work for InfoWars, but he's an example of it, than CNN. And so their answer is, have CNN, the New York Times, BuzzFeed, and all these other corrupt organizations openly lobby for us to be removed and then organize their listeners, their viewers, the different university organizations, Antifa, Sleeping Giants, and a bunch of other groups to then go mass flag us in the community guidelines, which again is something out of 1984 or a Kafka novel where you don't even know what you've supposedly done. You can't face your accusers. Then you get defamed by the claims of the big tech giants when they ban you. Make no mistake, this is being set up to create a precedent, in their own words, for you. Nationalists, conservatives, libertarians, Christians, people that stand up to the New York Times editorial board member saying whites are subhuman and should be extincted. This is the agenda they're pushing that is being funded by Communist China. And out of everything I've broken down so far, that's the key. Apple has officially moved to China and is letting the government basically run Apple. And that, of course, is iTunes. Google is building a huge censorship search engine for them, and whistleblowers from inside Google say they're preparing to use it here in America. In fact, they're beta testing different parts of the censorship system for China on American conservatives, nationalists, and Trump supporters. So bigger than just trying to manipulate the election and give huge contributions in kind to the Democrats by blocking conservatives, libertarians, conservative candidates, conservatives in office, and trying to make sure they can win back the House to try to impeach Trump, that's only one part of it. The bigger issue is they don't like InfoWars exposing the fact in great detail that Communist China owns our debt, owns and controls Hollywood now, is involved in massive domestic propaganda operations, and is working with the Democratic Party and with the EU and others to try to block the Trump agenda. They even talk about this at Davos. So this is 21st century warfare. It's happening right now, and it's designed to silence the American people and other populist movements around the world who are trying to struggle free from this corporate totalitarianism. I've had a lot of top lawyers call me today, and they say, Alex, we need to sue Apple. We need to sue all these groups. They clearly are involved in cut and dry antitrust activities, working with other big corporations to delist you and block you from the marketplace of ideas. So then when they demonize you, you don't have a way to respond to them and they can destroy you. And then with that model, move on against everybody else. Almost 5 months ago, the Wall Street Journal had the new CEO of News Corp brag that by 2019, the internet will be basically paid. He said, Barry Diller's also said this as well. He owns Newsweek, so that's a Democrat on the other side, that the internet will be paid soon. Watch, believe me, he said, because they're setting the precedent to deplatform InfoWars and WikiLeaks as the test point example. And once they've done that, they're doing it to everybody. Now, what do we need to do? We need to call the White House, go to Trump's rallies, call the campaign, let them know that this is about deplatforming conservatives and libertarians and other Republican candidates around the country to steal the election. It's true election meddling, not like the made-up Russia meddling garbage. This is out in the open and naked. And the Democrats have been very, very public about it. So if we simply have real congressional hearings about this, where I'm called and others are called, they will be exposed. They've had a bunch of hearings lying about me, saying that I need to be deplatformed, but I'm never there to actually speak for myself. This is completely one-sided and totally deceptive because they can't handle me being there. So again, they secretly report you, they defame you, they lie about you, and then you never get to see what you've done or face your accuser. This is the essence of totalitarianism. And President Trump, the Republican Congress, the state houses, independent media all need to rally together against this global move to censor America and the planet. Because if you look at what Facebook, Google, Apple, and all of them are doing right now, it's mirroring the EU censorship. And why is that? The EU has been fining them billions of dollars if they don't get in line on hate speech and fake news, which is whatever Brussels and the unelected bureaucrats say it is. So it's China, the EU, and others muscling in on America with all these global regulations trying to force their will on us. France is passing laws to shut down populists. Brazil's passing laws to shut down populists. Whether they be left-wing or right-wing, they don't want the people having control of their own destiny. This is modern global corporate colonialism against every nation state on the planet, be you first world, old world, or be you a third world nation. This is history. It's happening now. And we're the tip of the spear at newswars.com, prisonplanet.com, and infowars.com. And that's because they're cold-blooded sociopathic scum who've been chosen and picked and prepared to go out and be henchmen and women to control and take down this nation. And they cold-bloodedly believe they've bet on the power structure and they're going to win. CNN, MSNBC, all of them are the very worst of the worst, who are not news organizations, but criminal racketeering combines, by the very definition, out operating to intimidate and attack and control and sabotage and block funds and bring down pro-America organizations. But in the end, we're going to defeat these people, and America and the world is going to be prosperous, and we're going to come through this together. That's a basic breakdown of what we're facing, what we're dealing with. China has basically allied with the globalists, the Democrats, the EU, and radical Islam to take down this country and take down the West. They are very afraid of us because we're exposing that, and that is the heart of the matter. Trump must take action now so they can't steal the 2018 election. He must take action and expose the true espionage of the communist Chinese infiltrating every level of our country and openly pushing for patriots to be silenced and censored. That is outrageous. And it's a hard truth to tell, but if the president tells it, even more Americans, as the polls show, will pick the right side of being pro-America, pro-liberty, pro-freedom, and pro-prosperity. But we've got to tell the very serious truths. And we've got to realize films like Death of a Nation by Dinesh D'Souza are so critical for everyone to see if you want to understand the real threat.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
2.5 years ago, Hillary Clinton dubbed myself and InfoWars as fake news. Since then, the Democrats in Congress, CNN, MSNBC, have all lobbied to keep me from publishing books, to have us kicked offline from Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, and they've had some success. Not only are they the real fake news and working for the communist Chinese and others to overthrow this country, they're also working to destroy the First Amendment here in America.